I'm reading from Mark, chapter 4, first 20 verses of that, if I may, please. And again, Jesus began to teach by the sea, and a great multitude was gathered to him, so that he got into a boat and sat in it on the sea, and the whole multitude was on the land facing the sea. Then he taught them many things by parables. Jesus said, let me tell you a story. He said one of these stories to them in this manner, in verse 3. Listen, behold, a sower went out to sow, and it happened as he sowed that some seed fell by the wayside, and the birds of the air came and devoured it. Some seed fell on stony ground, where it did not have much earth, and immediately it sprang up. In one reference it said, it sprang up with joy, but because it had no depth of earth, and when the sun came up, it was scorched. Because it had no root, it withered away. Some seed fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked it, and it yielded no crop. But other seed fell on good ground and yielded a crop that sprang up, increased and produced some 30-fold, some 60, and some 100. And he said to them, he who has ears to hear, let him hear. In other words, listen to me. But when he was alone, those around him with the 12 asked him about the parable. Basically, they said, what did that mean? And he said to them, to you it has been given to know the mystery of the kingdom of God. But to those who are outside, all things comes in parables, so that seeing they may see and not perceive, and hearing they may hear and not understand, lest they should turn and their sins be forgiven them. What Jesus is saying to his disciples here is, I communicate in a way that they will understand, that they will comprehend what I'm saying, because they don't comprehend the deep things that you have come to understand. And so he went on to explain to them, basically, why don't you understand the parable? How then will you understand all the parables? And he then goes to explain. The sower sows the word. The seed is the word of God. And these are the ones by the wayside where the word is sown. And when they hear, Satan comes immediately and takes away the word that was sown in their hearts. They likewise are the ones sown on stony ground who, when they hear the word, immediately receive it with gladness. They have no root in themselves and so only endure for a short time. Afterward, when tribulation and persecution arises, and they need the word, they stumble. Now these are the ones sown among thorns. They're the ones who hear the word, and the cares of this world, the deceitfulness of riches, and the desires of other things, entering in, choke the word, and it becomes unfruitful. These are the ones sown on good ground, those who hear the word, accept it, and bear fruit, some 30-fold, some 60, and some 100-fold. Jesus talking in stories to explain to them the process that happens as the word of God is sown in lives across the earth. The one thing that I noticed first of all about this is that the seed was sown in all the circumstances. Now, even in studying this, there's been times I've had a little bit of difficulty figuring out who's who and what's what. You know, who's the seed? What's the seed? Are we the ground or are we? And really, the seed, first of all, is the word of God. It's the word. The ground is really the circumstances or the situation that we find ourselves in as we receive the word. I've also come to feel that there's some in here that could actually, George, be talking about nations. And there's four circumstances that we find ourselves in as the word is sown in our life. The first is the area of what I call the hard pan. It's the sidewalk. Now, they didn't have concrete. They had these paths that went through their fields. And because they were the path that everybody traveled on, it was totally packed down, and it was impossible for a seed to take root and germinate in that path. so consumed with what everybody's doing, going where everybody's going, keeping up with the whomevers, that we're so at a pace of life that we're impenetrable, even by the word of God. The seed may be sown, but to be honest, we've got other things to do. To be honest, we're on the way somewhere. And we don't have time. And really, we're not that concerned about the word. There's a whole culture of people that we live amongst, and I pray that we're not one of, that are so concerned with all that life holds and all that this moment holds, that the things of God, the word of God, are really not that important. And to be honest, they're not bearing any fruit in their lives. The whole bottom line of this scripture is the bearing fruit part. It's that heavenly, eternal purpose that's lived out in our life. These that are just consumed with the pace and the path of life to where the word is impenetrable to them. Really just making it day by day. Really not making any effect for the kingdom of God at all. The next group that we talked about and that Jesus brought to our thinking was those who are on the, let me find it, stony ground. In Palestine, much of the land is a 2 or 3 inch veneer of soil over a limestone bedrock. And we lived in somewhat of this kind of territory in southern Missouri. And we were able to buy a new home there. And the first time I mowed the grass, it was like every 3 or 4 feet, bing, bing, there's rocks everywhere. And so, excuse me, I kept thinking, I'll pick up the rocks and clean the yard out, and I would, and it would rain a time or two, and I'd go and mow, and ping, 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 more rocks. And I finally found out, after living there a while, you never got rid of the rocks, because they were all underneath. They were a bed underneath the soil, and they kept working themselves up. And this was the way it was, except worse in Palestine, in that this 2 or 3 inches of soil was on this shale rock. It was just really a barrier. And when you planted seed, it would grow that deep. But there was no room for roots. There was no room for sustenance. And if it dried up a little bit, it got hot, scorched, it just withered. Because they were not planted in a way that sustenance could bring the continuance of the growth. We have a spot. If we have a little bit of a drought this summer, or a little bit of a heat wave, I want you to notice something very interesting in our yard out here. Between here and the Family Life Center, which was the original Catholic Church, there were 3 houses. There were 2-story, what I call shotgun houses. What that means is you can open the front door and the back door and shoot a shotgun through and it touches nothing. And there were 3 of these 2-story shotgun houses, long houses, in between these two buildings. Well, in time, we bought those houses and tore them down. And they're gone. Now, one of those houses had a basement. And you can actually, if you walk down the sidewalk, you can see where the sidewalks would go to these 3 houses. Because the little thing is there to connect the sidewalks. But the 3rd house over had a basement. And when it gets dry, when it gets hot, there's a square out there in the yard just the size of that basement. The rest of the grass is still green around it, but just at that spot, it turns brown. Why? Because there's that rock, that concrete, that is keeping the sustenance, the moisture, from coming. pointing up into that part of the yard. And that's what this scripture's talking about. It even says, as I mentioned, in one reference, in one translation, it said they received the seed with joy. They're glad to get the seed. But they're not willing to let it seep and sink into their lives. And when trouble comes, it's such a shallow experience. They don't have the word in their lives. They don't have the experience of the Spirit working in their lives. And so what they've got is this little bit of religiosity that, to be honest, is not enough. I love the church. I love church services. But if this is your only time you pray, you're on stony ground. If this is the only time you open the Word of God, you're on stony ground. If this is the only time you consider your spiritual walk and your spiritual life, you're on stony ground. And it won't suffice. Because the rain comes to the good and the bad. We all are going to have trouble. I wish I had a doctrine that could tell you that if you say the magic words, you'll never have another problem. But I don't believe it's true, and I believe the Word supports that. I believe as long as we're in this carnal flesh, we're going to have trouble. Now, are you going to survive that, or are you going to throw it? Is that you have going to wither? I've had so many people through these years come to me, and I won't see them for a while. You know, they'll just be kind of gone. And all of a sudden, they'll visit, and I'll say, well, where you been? Well, I've been going through a real trouble. Well, you have, yeah. Why didn't you come to church? Oh, I didn't feel like coming to church. I just didn't feel like coming to church. I was having a hard time. Well, have you delved into the Word? Oh, I didn't feel like reading the Bible. That just helped me. I was having a hard time. One, I said, well, have you listened to any music? Because they love the praise music. Have you been listening to any? No, I didn't feel like it. I didn't feel like that praise music. I asked one lady, I said, well, what have you been doing? And she said, oh, I'm just sitting at the house watching soap operas. I mean, that's going to help you a whole lot. That's living on stony ground. You need, as John said in the service yesterday, you need an anchor for the soul. When hard times come, you need the Word of God. You need the Spirit and the presence of God. That's shallow. Then it talked about thorny ground. Roots of the thorn bush, far-reaching in Palestine, took time for the thorns to grow out through the field. And eventually, those thorns would take over. We have some of those kind of plants. Somebody gave us some ground cover. I don't remember what the name of it was. But they warned me. They said, now, watch this. It'll take over your flower bed. It'll kill everything in it. You don't watch it. Keep it cut back. Those vines that we see on the edge of the road, I think kudzu, is that what they call it? That stuff will kill everything because it's going to have its place.